There is no perfect journey.
What stays behind?
What lies beyond?
Determination, passion, and prayer.
If we believe in ourselves,
our dreams turn into reality.
One mind, one heart.
Who will take the challenge?
Who will take the challenge?
Here in USA,
University of San Agustin.
We are ready.
We are ready to support you.
There is no perfect journey.
Whatever stays behind and lies beyond,
it should all be worth it.
It should all be worth it.
We are one.
We are one.
We are 100.
We are 100.
100.
We are 100.
And the journey behind being one and achieving 100
lies behind 56 years of quality education and beyond.
So I hope you like that short video presentation. So again, now I would like to thank Ma'am Hai and the rest of those involved in this program. So technically, what is really medical laboratory science? So you already know that, no? Formerly, this is known as medical technology. So right now, this is being called as medical laboratory science. In North America, this is called clinical laboratory science. So we are under with the College of Health and Allied Medical Professions. So why medtech? Or why medical clinical laboratory science? So these persons are called medical technologists or clinical laboratory scientists. Okay? So probably you are wondering, what is this picture? Has something to do with these thoughts, of course, no? Okay. So, medtech is the health profession that provides laboratory information and services needed for the diagnosis and treatment of disease. And those persons working in this field are called as medical laboratory scientists. They actually work to analyze a variety of biological specimens. They are responsible for performing scientific testing on samples and reporting results to physicians. So in other words, ang atong mga doktor, hindi sila maka-diagnose without the results coming from the laboratory. Somehow they could diagnose physically, but of course, you could not get the correct facts, the correct things in diagnosing without the results coming from the laboratory. And these are the persons who are actually working. And because of that, the doctors would be able to diagnose the condition of the patients properly because of those tests that the medtechs are doing. Okay, so yes. So the MLS education in our country is actually a 4 years program or a 4-year program. So from first year to third year, we have the general education and professional courses. So if you would, if you think these are only all professional courses, but remember there are still other courses that you need to take. So when we talk about courses, we are actually referring to the subjects. So the program is referring to not the degree that you will earn later on. And the courses are actually the subjects. So you will still have subjects like psychology, you would still have subjects like English and even math, because all of these are actually needed for you to become a good laboratory scientist. So hindi lang basta professional courses. All of these professional courses are actually dependent also on those general education courses, because it's actually a whole package. Now, on the fourth year, this is now the terminal year because this is the internship year. So it's a 1-year internship So in the previous CMO, we actually reduced it from a 1 year to 6 months, but eventually the technical committee on the MedTech education realized that if we reduce that into 6 months, it is not enough. So eventually they realized that they have to return it back, no, to a 1 year internship. You would have rotations on all affiliated training laboratories. And the good thing is that here in the University of San Agustin, we also have a training laboratory. We call it as the USA Clinical Laboratory. Okay, so aside from the affiliated training hospitals that we have seven actually. So we also have our in-campus clinical laboratory. That's the USACL. Okay, so what are the areas of the MLS practice? Actually, we could only sum up into four. So technically, if you would not be working, eventually, you know, when you graduate, when you earn the degree, after finishing the program, you have to pass the board in order for you to practice. So you have choices. Either you go directly, no, to take up medicine. So MLS is a good preparatory background. Of course, there are other allied health sciences there that would also serve for you to have as a background to take up medicine. But I might be biased to say that the medical laboratory science is a very good preparatory course degree for you to become a medical doctor. So what are the other areas whereby you could actually work after finishing your degree? So in research and even in the academe. So in my case right now, I am in the academe. I'm actually preparing students to become professional MLS. So together with my faculty, so we are working in the academe. So here in San Agustin. So what other areas that you could actually go into? Become a product specialist. What are product specialists? These are actually the ones who monitor all aspects of product equipment, chemical diagnostic kit, the life cycle, including now the long short-term product, develop and marketing. So that's also the work of the medical technologists, because take note, technically you might be confused with the sales rep or the medical rep. Actually, there's just a term for it, particularly with MedTech, we call it as product specialist. As the term suggests, product specialist. So they are the ones selling, marketing, this equipment to be used in the laboratory. So in general, it's not only for the laboratory, you could also use it in the hospital in general, but specifically in the laboratory, this would include the microscopes, what else? The centrifuge, autoclaves, all of these are actually under the product specialist. So another evolving trend in the MLS practice, it's very in demand right now, is to become a forensic, no? Scientist or a criminalist. These are the ones involved in collecting evidences and analyze the evidence in the laboratory and summarize their findings in written reports. So you could work in the NBI, you could work in the police, or any other branches whereby it involves forensics. Okay, so technically this would be a very good background. For example, you want to enter into the service, the military service, or into the PNP. So a very good background person before getting into the service, it would be good that you should be a graduate of MedTech first, so that when you enter the service of the PNP or AFP, so likely you would have chances of becoming a forensic, no, investigative or detective, or shall we say as criminalist. Okay, now of course, the most important thing about the graduates of this program is to work in the hospital laboratories. So this is where we are actually identified. We perform tests in helping the doctor diagnosing the medical condition of the patient. So all of this, I think you have heard already about this, performing complete blood chemistry, complete blood count, no, HEPA test, and even the antimicrobial susceptibility test, even your routine urinalysis and routine fecalysis. These are actually being done by medical technologists. The evolving trend right now, particularly during these times in the pandemic, you've heard about molecular biologists. So medtechs who are trained to work in the molecular laboratory, not to work in diagnosing patients who might be suspected for COVID. Remember, it's not only COVID that we are actually doing testing in the molecular biology, lots of things. And the last, of course, but not the least, MLS could also work as a microbiologist, is our specific field, or even as a drug analyst. Okay, so why should you enroll at the USA, the University of San Agustin, and why the MLS program? Then again, it's not only about the board passing percentage. It's a whole package, believe me. So you would have a good environment here. Now it's not only with the program, but other all facilities and well-rounded professors, you will be meeting them during your entire stay in the university for 4 years. So it's a whole package. But of course, our ultimate goal here for you, no, is actually to make you pass the board. But again, I would say it's just also a cliche, but beyond that, we actually would help you transform. We journey along with you in your entire stay with the university. So as you can see here, the latest that we can show you and we are very proud of, and this is Raven John Bourbon Bernales, a native of Capiz, is actually working with us right now as of the moment. Of course, as a part-time college instructor, he also used to work as a molecular biologist there in Capiz. So the University of San Agustin Medical Laboratory Science is a level 2 PASCO accredited. Well, this program was actually created in the year 1962. It's all started with the program of the BS Pharmacy. So if you heard about it, probably could ask stories from your Lola and Lolo. So BS Pharmacy siya sang una, but eventually what happens, because in the terminal year in the pharmacy, some would go into the pharmacy practice, some would go into the laboratory. So there was this Republic Act that was created, no? Enacted, then eventually this program was born, known as the BS Medical Technology. And in the entire history of the Agustinian Order, particularly with the academe, the University of San Agustin is the only university of the Agustinians in the Asia Pacific region. So, okay, in terms of facilities, what do I have to say? We have the research laboratories. We have here the C2B2, the CND3, the Center for Informatics. Now we have here the DOST, Tuklas Lunas Center. And for you, no, it's not only becoming a student of the program. In fact, even if you will graduate later on and who are interested still to work on research, we have these facilities waiting for you to use it. Of course, we have to delineate these research laboratories from the instructional laboratories. The instructional laboratories, these are the laboratories from which you would be acquainted with, starting with the first year. So this, the courses, the subjects starting with biology and chemistry, all of these are part of the instructional laboratories. And when you reach third year, we have the medical technology lab that's still part of the instructional laboratories. But then again, when you pass the qualifying exam, now for internship, you would know experiencing all of these things about the training, particularly in the clinical laboratories of this university as well as the hospital affiliation laboratories. Okay, so this would include equipment, the use of analyzers. The one that I'm showing to you right now, these are just simple analyzers that this clinical laboratory has. But of course, we have state of the art. And what's the good thing about the practice in the University of San Agustin Clinical Laboratory is we teach the old technology as well as the new technology. And we are very proud about it. Why? Because once you graduated and somebody would ask you, sa din ikaw nag-intern? So likely, if you would say clinical laboratories in San Agustin, and they would say, okay, that's good, that's good. Why? Because if you become a professional and you would happen to encounter problems in your machine and you need to come up with the results, and the good thing is you were taught how to do conventional things. You were taught to do traditional things. For example, when doing blood count. So when doing blood count, if the machine bogged down, you could do manual blood count. And that's very good. And we are still doing that here. Okay? So the University of San Agustin Medical Laboratory Sciences consistently produce, no, board top notchers. Aside from being a board top notchers, no, take note of this. I'm showing to you right now the data. For the last 5 years, we have been consistently above the national passing. We don't fall below 80%. From year 2014, we had this 86%, whereby compared to the national passing, we only had 71%. And of course, the latest one that we have is 91.61 compared to the national passing of 73.5%. So we assure you, once you are here, no, at the University of San Agustin, we would take care of you. But of course, no, it's like saying we dance together.